Do you consider leopards essential in the evolving modern day landscape? So we basically asked them whether you want the leopards for the next 50 years. And see, 92.7-93% people said that we want leopards, which is a very interesting thing. Then could you envisage a future without leopards? 90% said no, so they want the leopards. That indicates the awareness towards the conservation. Jalana also acts as a heat sink for the city. And of course, persistence of all wildlife benefits. This is the same boy you can see in all the pictures. So there is a constant interface. There is a very good coexistence with the animals here. He is rescuing a fox. There is a leopard here. There is a hyena here. The leopard is inside the house now. So, pro-conservation attitude. Many of the villagers, they are helping the nature and the animals there by creating water holes, by creating let's not say food banks. It's not a restaurant that we are talking about in Kruger, but they do have water holes prepared for the animals. This was the earlier stage. We all know the Maharajas, Britishers, and all of us, whenever we get a chance, we shot down the animals. Now we have come to this. There is a leopard picture. Now this is actually the culture of India. If you see, we almost have one animal for every god. So which is very important in conservation. And of course, look at this gentleman. He has painted all his tool by save leopard, leopard pictures. So wherever he goes, he sends a message. Then of course, we have a team of researchers who is working, international team. Then of course, the local villagers, they want to participate in the conservation process, which makes a direct impact. So just my goodwill is not sufficient. They are actually participating in that, which is very interesting. So conclusion, sharing of resources with leopards, frequent human-leopard interactions, of course. No recorded fatal attack on humans. That is the main reason why there is coexistence. In all other cases, there is a direct impact or direct conflict because there is some kind of a loss or something there. No retaliatory behavior, high level of awareness, and proactive conservation. Okay, now why understanding human-animal conflict is essential. See the biodiversity. Kruger, 336 tree species, 147 mammal species, 517 bird species, and reptiles 114. Namibia, look at the bird species, 676. Reptiles 250. Jalana, 29 square kilometer we are talking, and it's 220 tree species we have. What? 33 mammal species in this small, you know, green patch that we have here. 132 bird species and 20 reptile species. It's a very rich forest. If we have to protect or conserve the biodiversity of this particular habitat, we should understand what are the factors that are affecting the loss of it. So human-animal conflict is one part of it. Of course, there are other parts, but basically with all the other factors coming in, finally it boils down to the human-animal conflict, where we are encroaching their space or they are encroaching our space. I mean, they, in the sense, humans and non-humans, let's put it that way. So understanding this human-wildlife conflict and working towards a coexistence is very important. So what we can conclude here is, Jalana is a very unique case of coexistence, in spite of the fact that there is a big predator, which is a carnivore, an active carnivore, a healthy carnivore, and in similar cases, similar geographical belts, Kruger, Namibia and Jalana, they are all in the tropics. The Tropic of Cancer passes through Jaipur, Tropic of Capricorn passes through Kruger and Namibia. So the same tropical belt, but different conditions. And we see that there is a coexistence in Jaipur, in Jalana, and there is a conflict in all other places. So what we are trying to do is, we are trying to devise a mechanism which can be replicated in all other parts of the world to reduce the coexistence, which ultimately will really help in conserving the biodiversity. We always think of for me it was always the top predator of the trophic pyramid, the leopard or the tiger or the lion. But once you understand the habitat or the ecosystem, then you understand why every part is essential. Every component is a very vital screw in the mechanism. And that's why it needs to be conserved. We do our best, we do our bit, and hopefully all of us do that. And with this biodiversity conservation, I guess we all are inspired to put in some more effort towards this goal. Thank you very much.
Any questions, please? Does anybody want to ask a question?
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.